You know, Renew Evansville, a lot of people ask me about what is that. And when you think of it in the context that Renew Evansville is probably the largest public works project the city of Evansville has ever been faced with.
Renew Evansville is a comprehensive plan to make significant upgrades to Evansville's sewer system and make dramatic improvements in the operations and day-to-day management of the system as well. Over the next 20 plus years, folks will see a lot of projects around the community, a lot of green infrastructure. They're going to see things changing on the surface of Evansville that really addresses and improves one of Evansville's most important assets, its sewer system.
What's unique to Evansville is we have a small population base, but a very big city problem here. How we're approaching that is to spread it out longer over time.
The project really is about a couple of things. One is addressing a combined sewer system in part.
A combined sewer overflow, also known as a CSO, is when sewage and stormwater mix and flow directly into a waterway without treatment. So in Evansville, the CSOs discharge into Beast Slough, the Ohio River, and Pigeon Creek. It's important to know where those outfalls are so that during and after rain events, the public can stay out of the water because there is raw sewage in the water.
That's really unacceptable, and there's a federal mandate that Evansville needs to address that issue.
You know, a lot of people ask, what is a consent decree? That's not a part of our normal terminology that we use every day. Another way to think about it is it's a federal mandate. It's fundamentally to ensure that waterways, such as the Ohio River here, is clean. The EPA was charged with the responsibility to enforce the Clean Water Act and requiring cities to not put sewage into the Ohio River or other rivers.
And so over the last several years, EPA and the Indiana Department of Environmental Management have been putting communities under increasing pressure to get their plans done and to begin implementing their plans.
And now there are literally hundreds, there's probably 700 plus cities in the United States that have a federal mandate to fix their systems. The Long Range Control Plan is a $540 million project. Now it's $540 million spent over what we're advocating is over a 28-year period. A couple of the key priorities that we have with the initial program is to address the Beast Slough problem that we have. We're increasing the capacity of our treatment plants to treat more wastewater. We are creating storage throughout the city, and we are using green infrastructure to redirect stormwater so that it doesn't get into the stormwater system and it goes into the ground and gets absorbed there naturally.
It's focused around a problem that for generations people have pushed off and have ignored, largely ignored. More importantly is that the utility is increasing its effectiveness and increasing its level of service to its customers, and in general, improving the quality of life for everybody, not just for the neighbors around the combined sewer systems or the people that use the waterways. So it's about more than combined sewer overflows. It's about effective maintenance and operation practices as well.
The long-term plan that Evansville is proposing and the mandate really is driven by the 1972 Clean Water Act. So that's an act that's been around for a while. These mandates have been in place for a while. But like a lot of cities, Evansville hasn't addressed it, and really over the years has sort of underinvested in its assets.
And over the next 3 years, we have 111 projects we're working on, and that's just the beginning. So there's a lot of moving parts to this. But at the end of the day, it's a good solution.